Hello, welcome back to Little Busters. After school, I went straight to the library to do research on the meteor shower Komari San had mentioned. Okay. There was a small number of students in there studying for the upcoming exam. The exam, in fact, was optional. You didn't have to take it unless you wanted to find out how much you had improved. Anyway, that was none of my business since I wasn't going to take it. I looked for books. Even though I checked as many books as I could find, I couldn't find exactly what I wanted to know. Which meteor shower was she talking about? Timing-wise, I guess the June Herdsman meteor shower would be the one. But according to the books, it was only observed once in 1927. There are no other possible ones, though. Could Komari-san have been mistaken? Well, before doubting her, I should do some more research. But how should I continue? The internet's pretty good. I'm gonna use the internet. Okay, I'll check the web. There were several computers with internet connection in the library. I typed in some keywords and pressed enter. No results. Seriously? I never imagined this would happen. I recalled the meteor shower had an alias. I typed in Ponswinek meteor shower. Lots of hits. I clicked on each of the links from the top. What I found on those sites was almost the same as what I'd learned from the books. Oh. It was unexpectedly observed in 1998. Maybe this is it then? According to that article, the meteor shower was still active. However, it had become so weak now that you could hardly notice it with the naked eye unless you were very lucky. Actually, someone reported that they had observed it without a telescope in 2004. You needed good luck, huh? I abridged the article and wrote it down in a notebook. I wonder who I should pray to for shooting stars. What an absurd question to have. Lunchtime. I think we need to talk about the meteor shower. She glanced up at me, munching on a rice cracker. You haven't told me when to go watch it, have you? I don't think so. It was totally sudden. Is the meteor shower at its peak tonight?
Riki-kun, 思い立ったら吉日ですよ。足踏みなんてしてたら素敵なことはどんどん逃げていっちゃいます。
It was yesterday that we decided to do that, though. I didn't actually mind much that it was tonight, since we didn't need much preparation. But are you sure it's here now?
うん。本当にここ。
What if the guard caught us on the way up here? Wait a minute. Students weren't allowed up here in the first place. I'd completely forgotten that and had been frequenting here with no sense of guilt. I'm an accomplice, aren't I? She gave me an unnecessarily delighted smile. We decided to meet up at the school gate at 10. Late in the evening, our room. I checked the time. It was a good time to leave. I packed snacks I had stored in our room into a bag. Hey, I'm going out. I spoke to Masato, who was doing sit-ups. What was that? I know it's night now, by the way.
え?夜って分かったって出かけやがるのかよ。今ちょうど筋トレが終わって、お前に声をかけようとしてたのに。
Keep training. I'm gonna go stargazing.
Tempura kanshoku?
Stargazing. You could see a lot of shooting stars tonight. Not interested?
全然ねえな.
I kinda knew it. Hey, did you know? The motif of the constellation Hercules is a huge muscled guy.
Ah! Sore mite! Yeah, narite! さ、モチーフになったやつが羨ましいぜ。
He quickly tuned in on the world muscle.
よし、俺も筋肉の星になる。
He made a passionate declaration.
そういうわけで、俺は筋トレに励むとするぜ。鍵は開けといてやるから、バレねえように戻ってこいよ。
Okay. I left the room with a wave. I arrived at the school gate. She wasn't there yet. I took a look at my cell phone and saw that there was still a little left until the meeting up time. Looks like I came here a bit too early. I decided to call her if she didn't show up on time. Something made me turn around to look at the school building. The building veiled in darkness seemed a different realm altogether from the one in the morning. Going to school. Cool at night really is different. As I was thinking that, clang, 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 I heard sounds coming from around the gate. What was that? It was too dark and too far to see what it was. I went over there. Clang, clang, the same sound again. Now I spotted somebody in front of the gate. They appeared to be trying to climb over the gate to enter the school property. They noticed me. She spewed out the explanation with great impetus. Komari-san? Take it easy, it's me. yes.
びっくりしたよ。怒られると思ってついついごまかしきっちゃったよ。
Girl, you're not fooling me. That was no excuse at all. Why were you outside of the school grounds?
ほら、あれだよ。お菓子の買い出しに行ってたんだよ。
She proudly lifted up a plastic bag to show me. Anyway, come over in here.
うん、そうするよ。
She prepared to jump onto the gate again.Her knee got stuck between the gate bars. I found myself letting out a sigh. You really should plan ahead every once in a while. I gave her an honest piece of advice.
私は大丈夫だったつもりなんだけど。
What a shallow thought. With my help, she managed to get over the gate.
やっと戻れた。
We made a lot of noise. Seemed like no one had heard it, though.
すっごい遅刻しちゃった。リキ君、ごめんなさい。
Never mind that, and please turn your voice down. She was pretty inept at acting covertly. We snuck into the building through a window of the second art classroom that had no security system. Komari-san had found the route. This is way more thrilling than I expected. Even if we were caught, we should be able to make reasonable excuses given that we were students of the school.I realized I was growing more brazen.
電気つけちゃうと宿直の人に見つかっちゃうから明かりはなしで行こう。
Okay.
リキ君、こっちだよ。
Pulling me by the hand, she was making her way up toward the roof. Our light sources were exit signs and the moonlight leaking in through windows. We made careful headway when there was neither of them.I had been too excited to be afraid during the trial of courage, but I'm pretty tense this time. It's not like I believed in ghosts or anything like that, but I couldn't help but feel frightened. What existed in darkness? Fear itself. Komari-san, aren't you scared? I asked her as she was leading me by the hand. I guess she should also be scared, since I knew how she had been during the trial of courage.
私だって怖いよ。だから、これ。
She raised the hand she was using to hold mine. By holding hands, she was trying to choke back her fear. Being with somebody else made you braver. I decided to walk abreast of her. When we finished climbing up the stairs, we saw green light through the piled desks and chairs. That rhymed. She heaved a sigh of relief. She must have been more frightened than I had imagined. Let me open up the window. I opened the window and we made our way outside. We looked up to the sky. There were only thin clouds drifting in the distance. Thank God, nice weather. Excuse me. She was all smiles. Saying so, she walked up to the railing.
Riki-kun! Yeah?
I stood next to her and saw what she was seeing. Above us shone the innumerable stars of a night sky, and below us the countless lights of the city. Both looked like a sea of stars. It's amazing. I do. It might not be such a big deal to other people, but at least to me, it was the most beautiful scene I had ever seen. You know what? You are great.
I
doubt it. Okay. We'd climb up to the water tank, which we were very familiar with. She raised her foot onto the ladder. Me neither, and I was curious what it was like up there. Hey, Komari-san. I think you should go after me. She grabbed her skirt with both hands. And she lost her balance. Oh, I supported her back. Are you okay? I'm worried that you'll get seriously injured someday. You have to be more careful. I sighed. We got up to the top of the tank. Wow, it feels so high up here. And also pretty dangerous since there was no bar or anything. Well, you could say that. We both sat down and waited for shooting stars to appear. Either is fine to me. She took out two cans of coffee. I'll pay for them. Really? We opened the cans and drank. Very bitter, isn't it? She didn't answer. Komari-san? I looked at her. The bitterness of the coffee was written plainly on her face. You don't have to force yourself to drink it. She gave it another try. She put an effort in the most useless places. I brought some chocolate. That should lighten the bitterness, I guess. I handed her an almond chocolate. She happily gobbled it up, and then drank the coffee again. I'll finish yours too.
苦いのが平気ってのだけはわかんない。
Actually, I don't really like it either. I think the question is whether or not you get used to it. And I assume you're always eating sweet things.
そんなことないよ。しょっぱいのも食べてるよ。
Such as?
ポテチとかおせんべいとか、ハッピーターンも美味しいよ。
Seemed like it was all snacks either way.For perhaps an hour, we enjoyed eating, watching the sky.
なかなか見えないね。
Right. I recall that we needed luck to see them. Come to think of it, I'm not particularly lucky. That meant I had to count on Komari-san's fortunes. But I got the feeling she was in the same boat as I.
流れ星が流れるようにって、何にお願いすればいいのかな？
She murmured ponderously. I couldn't help but laugh.
そんなおかしなこと言っちゃった私。
Yeah, you did. It was funny because I was thinking the same thing. I also wondered who one was supposed to ask for shooting stars.
それはちょっと面白いね。
We both laughed. I thought I might have come to be what she called an ordinary person. I still hadn't seen any shooting stars this entire time. She was nodding off. Komari-san? As I spoke aloud, her head bolted up.
ね、寝てないよ、寝てない。
Well, if I had left her alone here, she would have slept until morning.
やっぱり苦いのを我慢するしか。
Actually, black coffee doesn't completely erase your sleepiness.
そうなんだ。それじゃあ、お話でもしてましょうか。
That'd be better than just staring up at the sky.
じゃあ、そうしましょう。
Without rest, she hopped from one subject to another. Most of them were about the Little Busters members.
あの時のユイちゃん、かっこよかったよね。
Don't call me Yui-chan. I felt like I could hear Yukurukai-san say that from nowhere. You sure had a lot of fun.
これからだって楽しいよ。
Oh, so good.
いろいろね。
She smiled happily while she spoke. It looks so good.
みんなと一緒にいて楽しいのは、みんなといるのをお互いに幸せに思うから、そんな幸せがいっぱいあるから楽しいのです。
True, she's smart.
リキ君も分かってくれるかな。分かってくれたら、私もリキ君の幸せになれるといいな。
Then I have to make you happy too.
リキ君はもう私に幸せをくれてるよ。
She sounded surprised as she answered.
だって、みんなとだって、リキ君がいなきゃ一緒にいなかったかもしれない。リキ君は私のお星様だね。
She declared with a smile. That's pretty cheesy. I suppose that she might be looking at things the same way as the penguin in that picture book. She suddenly raised her voice in an exclamation.What? Really? It was too sudden.
流れ星ってね、本当に一瞬だから三回お願い事するなんてきっと無理だね。
Gee, and I missed it.
よし。
Yeah, alright.
リキ君も分かってくれた。
She smiled with a hint of embarrassment.
ねえ、リキ君はお願い事するとしたら、なんてする？
Let's see. If I could look at things like she did, I would probably be able to spend the rest of my life in happiness. I wish for your happiness.
わあ、すごいね。私と一緒。両思いだ。
I didn't understand why she was suddenly so bashful. By the way, I think you're really good at finding such things. All kinds of nice things. On the contrary, I'm terrible at it. What is it? She put her finger on my temple. I closed my eyes in surprise. Her murmured words were somehow sad. That reminded me of how she had been gazing up to the sky disconsolately the other day, but she withdrew her finger. She opened her mouth. Yeah? Yeah, I've heard the origin of Little Red Riding Hood is pretty grim. Yes.
ネロの絵の才能も認められてね。なんか突然お父さんとか出てきて、ネロもパトラッシュもすごく幸せな終わり方をするの。
Whoa. Sounds like it's a completely different story.
一緒に見てたお父さんも笑ってた。でも私はそれがすごく好き。だってそれって悲しいお話を 誰かが救ってあげようって思ったってことだから。だから私は。それがすごく好きなんだ。I
see. Thinking about it like that makes the movie sound pretty nice.
そんなにすごい話じゃないよ。私はそう思うってだけだから。だから、とっても普通、すごく好きな人たちがいてね。その人たちの笑ってるのが一番好きだったら、私はそのみんなに笑っていてほしいって思うから、みんなそうだと思うんだ。だから、普通。
I see. Right, that brought back the story of her brother she had told me. Sad stories never suited her. I didn't yet know how the story had ended, although I hoped it had a happy ending. Hey! I yelled out. A ray of light shot across the sky. And then it was gone quickly. That was a shooting star?
Riki-kun も見えたんだね。よかった。
It was really quick. But beautiful.
そう言ってもらえると嬉しいです。ここに誘ったの私だから、喜んでもらえると私も嬉しいよ。
Actually, that was the first time I've ever seen one. Impressive.
冬の流星群の方がもっと綺麗なんだよ。寒いし、見るの大変だけどね。
Sounds tough.
見に行けたらいいね。その時も二人で。
Me too. And we're gonna need some hot cocoa, which is not bitter.
苦いのはやっぱりダメ。
We were waiting for shooting stars, chatting amiably like that. It was around 2 in the morning. Komari-san was nodding off again, her head bobbing. Komari-san. I poked at her shoulder. I didn't think she could keep going any further. Let's go back.
そうしますか。
After I collected the snack wrappings and put them in a bag, we started getting off of the tank. I felt nervous while Komari-san sleepily clambered down the ladder. Are you okay? She rubbed her eyes.
多分大丈夫。
She was obviously not used to staying up. She shook her head twice and looked up to the sky. Eh? Of course it was too late.
Manoga. Saigo ni naru no kana? Nanatsume tte ne.
Darn. I missed two of those, the first one and the last. She gave a sudden shout.
Saigo datte omotta no ni na.
Eh?
Mou ikko nagaretan da. Saigo datte omotta no.
She looked disappointed somehow. The more shooting stars, the better, right?
So da ne. Riki-kun.
Yeah?
Matsuri no shoujo, shitteru?
Yeah, of course I know.
Ja, itsu no hanashi ka wa?
I thought it was winter. Christmas?
Are ne? Omisoka no hanashi nan da yo.
Oh, is that so?
Tabun ne. Watashi ga zettai ni suki ni narenai o hanashi. Kaeru ka?
She grinned. Sure. The night of stargazing came to an end. Even in bed, I was still thinking about Komari-san's last words. Next day. As you might expect, I was pretty sleepy.
Nando, 朝から随分眠そうだな。
Yeah, I couldn't sleep enough last night. I went stargazing.
流れ星?
Yeah, Ponce with Nick, if I'm not mistaken.
昨日?
Yes.
確かその流星群の極大化は、リキ、見られたのか?
Yeah, but just a few.
そうか。いや、そういうこともあるんだろうな。
は?
綺麗だったか?
Yeah.
そうか。
He sounded like there was a deeper meaning. Well, it was just a waste of time to mull over each of his words. I arrived in the classroom. Morning, Komari-san.
Ohayou gozaimasu!
She shook her head. She rubbed her eyes. She was already nodding off, and she smacked her head on the pencil box on her desk. She looked so sleepy.
そんなことないよ。大丈夫だよ。
As I suspected, it looked like she really wasn't good at staying up. Lunchtime on the way to the roof. She seemed to have gone there ahead of me. She looked sleepy all morning, so I suspected she would be sleeping again. I knew it. She seemed to have slid down from the water tank she had been leaning against, and her belly was now totally exposed. She's so defenseless. Was I supposed to fix her clothes? But it would be troublesome if she woke up right in the middle of me doing that. It probably wouldn't matter if I let her keep sleeping there, since it was warm today. I'm gonna fix her clothes, sure. It wouldn't be good if she got a sore stomach. Or if I was too embarrassed to see her like this. I have to make it without waking her up. I carefully grasped the hem of her shirt. Oh gosh! Our eyes met. And, of course, I was still holding her shirt. What was worse, though, was that her belly was still wholly exposed. I'm just... She was in a panic. I'm sorry, can you please let me explain?
Nandesuka?
She was utterly upset. You were sleeping with your belly exposed.
What?
In other words, I was just trying to cover it. Well, I am responsible too, but basically yes. I shouldn't have, I'm sorry. But I am the one who gave you the wrong idea. She bowed her head. Okay, I'm sorry. That was the solution she usually took. What's wrong? It was probably because the dream wasn't that important in the first place. Dreams. I recall she told me her brother only appeared in her dreams. Oh. I suggest that she forget about. I want to know. Ask her for details of the dream. Any chance you can remember something about the dream? I could get a hint from it. I really need you to do that. She pondered intently. Although she was trying so hard, there seemed to be nothing coming to her. Looks like it's a bit too hard. Thanks for trying. You should eat lunch now. It seemed as if she didn't like quitting halfway through something. She wouldn't stop even after I had finished my lunch. I put in a word to help her. Maybe it had something to do with your brother? I knew it. So, it was that after all. She started thinking it over. Your brother showed up, right?
So,
really? White and fluttering?
A
roof-like place with white and fluttering things. I had no idea what that place might be. However, it might be an important clue leading to her brother. But I definitely needed more information. The bell rang, signaling that there were 5 minutes until the next class. She was, how should I say, a peaceful person. We returned to our classroom. Although Komari-san was eating her lunch until the teacher came in, she couldn't finish it. Komari-san's voice rang out at the same time as her stomach grumbled.
Nanda, Kamikita. Hirumeshigurai shikkari kutte oke o.
The entire class was giggling. No one would have even noticed had she kept silent. After school, I was going to look into Komari-san's dreams. I wanted to know what meaning they might have in reality. As of now, Kojirou-san was the only one I could count on to find out something about her brother, Takuya Kamikita. Even so, I was still unsure whether he was really connected with the siblings, and above all, I had no reason to think he would give me a helping hand. Even though dreams were uncertain at best, and what Komari-san told me was unclear, it was worth an attempt. But I can't interpret dreams or any such thing. Searching seemed the only thing I could do. I thought I might try to ask somebody to teach me about dreams. Huh. I don't know. Ask Kyosuke or ask Kuya guys. I don't know. Which of these people would be better? I want to go with Kuya. Ask Kuya guys. I decided to ask Kuya guys. I caught her when she was leaving the classroom. Kuya guys, Sam, can we talk for a minute?
なんでしょうね? やぶから棒に。 まあ、別段急ぐ用事もない。構わんが。
I don't know who to ask for this. We moved to the courtyard. She said that we would not use the place where we had had a tea party this time because it was only available in cutting class.
して、リキ君。一体私に聞きたいこととは?
I'd like you to teach me about dreams.
夢? 将来に対する漠然とした不安か? うん。 そうしたことで悩むのはとてもよろしいことだぞ。
No, I meant those which you see during sleep.
うん。何故突然そんなことで悩み始めるのか、皆目見当もつかんが。まあ、この私で力になれるならば聞こうじゃないか。
Can you interpret dreams?
できるわけないだろう。
Ow.
それは心理学の範疇になる。 残念ながら私にそういった知識は圧倒的に不足しているのだよ。科学的に夢を説明することなら多少はできるが。Oh,
can you please do that?
それこそわけがわからんぞ、少年。まあ、簡単にな。さて、まず夢というものは何か。実のところ。 これを定義するものというのは未だない。人間の機能というものはそれぞれ何かしらの意義を持っているものだ。夢にはそれがない。全く無駄なものであるとも言える。Really? まあ、しかし夢の意義を唱える一説もある。夢は記憶の整理を行う機能とする説だ。Sort
it out?
例えばだ。嫌なことがあってむしゃくしゃしていたが、一晩経ったら何でもなく思えてきた。 という経験はないか?
I guess.
それは無意識下で夢がストレスを消化し、忘れさせているというのがこの説だ。Wow. とは言ったものの、この説は夢というものを記録できない以上、立証はできん。あくまで机上の空論ということだな。理屈的にはまあ正しいと言えるかもしれないが。
Wait, does that mean a dream only consists of one's memories?
原則はそうだ。 ただし、夢に扱われる記憶は非常にカオス的だ。整合性のない夢を多く見るのは、あらゆる記憶をひとまとめにして、デタラメに映像化しているためと言える。要するに、普段は手前しか使わない引き出しを机からぶっこ抜いてごちゃ混ぜにするようなものだな。
I see. So is it safe to say that all of your dreams are made out of your memories?
なかなか物分かりがいいぞ、少年。 今の理論だとそう解釈はできる。問題はまあ、そうだとは言い切れんことなんだが。さっき言った通り、立証のしようもないからだ。しかし、マテリアルのないものは構築できん。それは万物普遍の法則だ。そういった意味では、信用するに足る理論になるんじゃないかと、私は思うよ。All
right, thank you.
こんなものでいいのか。Very much so。うん。 そもそも君がこんなことで悩むとはよくわからんのだが、あれか、陰部か。少年たちの年頃はなかなか大変らしいな。No、I don't dream。それはそれで寂しいな。例えば、今日私とこうして会っていたことと、エッチなビデオを眺めていた記憶がごちゃ混ぜになって、素晴らしい陰部を見る可能性だってあるのだぞ。You're really, I'm not that perverted。 私が少年だったら口惜しくてキリキリして夜もおちおち寝ていられん。お姉さんのエロい夢見てとか パッション全開でいろいろブルンブルンさせることだろうよ。
Never in a thousand years.
まあ若いうちはいくらでも煩悩を抱えて生きるがいい。
I couldn't help but wonder which one of us was the one filled with earthly desires.
とりあえずこんなところで役に立てたかな。
Okay. Yeah, thanks.
何？ある種の悩みを抱えるのは千なきことだ。気に病まぬよ。
Even though a couple parts were abstruse, she had a knack for teaching. The next day, lunchtime. I headed to the roof like any other day. Huh? I could hear people talking. I peeped out of the window. It was Komari-san and Rin up there.
ちゃんの星はなんでつけてるんだ？
ふえん？これはね、願い星なんだよ。
願い星？
うん。お願い事があってね、叶いますようにってずっと昔からつけてるんだ。
They were chatting cheerfully. I didn't know they were getting along that well. It roused a deep emotion somewhere within me.Komari-san was talking to Rin so happily. Komari-san's wish. Could it be one about her brother? She had been worried about him all along. I had been planning to talk to her about her dreams. However, I was now hesitating to do so.
でもこれは秘密だから、あんまり話しちゃいけないんだよ。
そうなのか。わかった。約束だ。
I thought I should not interrupt them nor keep eavesdropping. I left the place. When I reached the lower hallway, I ran across Kiyosuke.
どうした？妙なところから現れたな。
Nothing really. Komari-san is with Rin right now.
そうか。
He smiled a little happily.
最近のリンはそこかしこからも引っ張りだこだからな。
How so?
あ、女子メンバーが特訓引っかえ、リンと昼休みに過ごしているみたいだ。
Really? That was hard to believe because she had always insisted on staying with us childhood friends. But it was truly good to know that she was getting along with people other than us. What?
お前も最近は他の誰かとばっかりだからな。マサトが寂しがってたぞ。
He must be right.
じゃあ今日はマサトとケンゴも集めて教室で食うか。
Good idea. Kiyosuke called them and the four of us enjoyed lunch together for the first time in a long while. Evening.I was thinking back on what had happened so far, sitting on the windowsill. Memory drawers. I could say at least that Komari-san had certain memories related to her brother or to somebody like him. Wait, but... It was also perfectly possible that her memories of some male character from some fictional story had become parts of these dreams of her brother appearing. What I learned might not help at all.
やべえ、シーツにお茶こぼしちまった。
Masato exclaimed loudly from inside the room. What are you doing, Masato?
仕方ねえだろ。エキスパンダーのスプリングが切れたんだよ。ペットボトルを直撃したからよかったものの、俺の方に飛んできてたらと思うとゾッとするぜ。
What's more horrible is that you got enough muscle to break your expander. First of all, you might want to hang the sheet out to dry and use another one.
ああ、すまねえな。
He held out the bed sheet toward me. Why me? You always make me take care of this kind of thing. Do it yourself for once.
心配すんな。それくらい筋肉でカバーしてやる。
I really can't imagine how that's possible, but entertain me.
そのうちあまりに発達した筋肉が分裂。俺の分身が大量発生する。そして、小人のように身の回りの世話をしてくれるのさ。
An image of a bunch of tiny Misatos cleaning our room and shouting, "Muscles! Muscles!" flashed through my mind. What an incomprehensibly gross fairy tale.
Yes! Sasuke Gambarze!
He began doing push-ups. Good luck. Leaning out the window, I hung the sheet on a clothesline. Having pinned it up, I set my foot on the sash bar again. Huh? Something that was white and fluttering. I recall Kamari-san's words. A sheet? A hung-out sheet. A roof. Something white and fluttering on a roof. I had witnessed that scenery, too. A hospital roof. No matter how I think about it, that seems right. I couldn't figure out any other facility where bedsheets might be hung on the roof, and where Kamari-san might have gone many times when she was little.
Oi, soro soro meshi da zo.
You can go without me.
Nanda yo. Mata samishii koto yuu na ttaku. Saikin no Riki wa mo.
He left the room murmuring to himself. If my guess is right, her brother may be already dead. No, there was the possibility that he was still alive, and there was some reason why he couldn't show himself to Kamari-san. Either way, the smell of death lingered in my mind. It might be better if we don't find him. Somehow I couldn't help but think that. Anyway, I shouldn't tell her about this idea. Phew. Yet there wasn't anything certain about him. What she had said was right. It might all be real, but it might all be a dream. I know one person who should know what's real and what's not. It came down to having to ask Kojirou-san after all. Never mind the attitude he had displayed the other day, he was certainly suspicious enough. Problem is, I'm pretty sure he won't tell me everything so easily. In the first place, I had gotten involved in a family matter. That was never a good thing to do. Nevertheless, finding out the truth would be meaningful. If he was alive, then Kamari-san could meet him again, but even if he wasn't, I could still hide it from her. No, either choice would be just my self-gratification. In the end, I was determined to go visit Kojirou-san the next day. At least I was certain of what I wanted to do now. Kamari-san and I were having lunch on the roof. Right. I completely forgot about that. And we wouldn't be able to spend lunch times here when it rains. She sighed heavily. Even you have things you dislike? Seemed like I had been biased toward her. Just like she always said, she was an ordinary girl. Except that she was the owner of eyes that could see things better than others. Well, too bad we won't be able to have lunch up here.
とってもしょんぼりなのです
Me too.
すごいね。またリオンも。どうしよう、どうしよう。
Her cheeks turned red in embarrassment as she spoke. Her way of thinking was too weird to follow sometimes.
とりあえず、スイートポテトパイでもどうぞ。
Thanks. She split the pie in two and gave me one of the halves.
おいしい?
Yeah, it's great. She also appeared happy with her pie. A smile really did suit her best. By the way, can we talk about the dream again?
Oh, dream?
The one about something white and fluttery.
そんな夢を見たような見なかったような。
You don't remember?
夢ってちょっと経つとすぐ忘れちゃうから。
But you remember dreaming of your brother, don't you?
Huh? それはできるだけ忘れないように、起きたら何度もそのことを思い出すの。
You want to meet him?
うん。本当にいるかもしれないのに、会えないって寂しいよ。でもどうやって探せばいいのかもわからないし。
I see. I couldn't tell her that he might be dead already.After school.
Riki, 今日は練習。
We do?
Yahoo! 放課後だ。今日も打ちまくるぜ。
Kengo in his crazy mode dashed away immediately.
なんだよ、Riki。お前も忘れてたのか
？I've got something else to do.
最近のお前は本当、俺たちのこと考えてるのかよ。寂しいじゃねえか。
Sorry, I can't tell you about it right now, but I need to have it done as soon as I can.So I can't join you guys today. When I said so, look, Rin hit me. That hurts.
さっさと行ってこい、薄なら飛んな。
With that, she rushed away.
さっさと用事済ませてこいってことじゃないか。
Kyosuke, he appeared out of nowhere.
別に練習参加は強制じゃない。大事なようなら。さっさと片付けてきゃ。
Okay. I wasn't sure things would go so smoothly though. I left the school and headed to the nursing home. When I told a woman at the counter that I was here to see Kojirou-san, she dealt with me genuinely. Genuinely? I don't know. She said it was very rare for young people like me to come.
きっと喜ぶわよ。
I hope so. I rather doubted it.Because he was kind of an unusual person himself. I explained to her that I knew where his room was and started there. The door of his room was closed like before, and it had a somehow intimidating air about it. I knocked on the door. Knock, knock. No reply. Kojirou-san? I opened the door.I took a step back.
Nanja, Kozou ka?
Did you always intimidate people when they try to enter your room?
Aisatsu mo nai burei mono ni wa touzen no koto yo.
I did call your name.
Koe ga chiisai nja, Kozou wa. Moppen yari naosei!
Why?
いいからやれと言ったらやらんか。大きな声で、ほがらか元気に子供らしい挨拶をすることから始めろ。わんぱくならなおよい。
I really don't want to. Okay, I'll try. I return to the hallway. How do you recognize me here? Kojirou-san, I came to see ya. I yelled out in a loud voice.The gazes of the people around felt like needles on my skin.
Yoshi, haire.
Understood! I got into the room.
Yareba dekiru janai ka, Kozou.
I'm very grateful for your words.
Yeah, mou ii zo. Jubun tanoshinda.
You made me do this just for entertainment.
まあ、追い先短いジジイのたむれじゃ、許せ。
I imagine an old man like you will live for another 80 years.
誰がじいさんじゃ
You just called yourself an old man, didn't you?
口の減らぬ小僧じゃ。
I give up. But I'm surprised you remember me.
そんなもん、嫌でも忘れんわい。
He guffawed again.And I'm also surprised that your room got so messy so fast.
この方が落ち着くんじゃ。
We spoke while I was cleaning the room. But what if trash takes over, even your sleeping space? You should have your room cleaned.
ほう、貴様は小僧のくせに、わしの連れと同じようなことを言う。
You mean Komari-san? I recall that he said his wife used to have the same name as the girl.
古い話よ。年を取ると 無駄に食べになっていかん。
He murmured as he turned his back to me. As I expected, he must be lonely. Kojirou-san.
なんじゃ?
Why do you keep Komari-san away from you?
わしは女子供は嫌いじゃと言っておるに、それに、あの娘は連れに似すぎておる。
I knew it. She is related to you, after all. He fell silent. There aren't that many people out there whose last name is Kamikita. Last name is the family name.
だとしたらどうする?
I want you to tell me about her brother. Silence again.
あの娘に何かあったか?
Not really, but...She told me he keeps showing up in her dreams over and over again. And she wants to meet him. I know it's rude to ask you like this, but finding him would be the only thing I can do for her. He drew in a breath.
小僧はどこまで知っている?
Honestly, I don't know anything at all. However, it seems a hospital might have something to do with him. And if so, he may already...
なるほど。
He closed his eyes and stiffened.
その病院とはここのことだ。
What?
小僧。
Yes.
ただの親切心のつもりならば、それ以上関わるな。事実はおそらく小僧の考えている通りじゃ。そしてできれば、そのことをあの子には伝えんでやってくれ。
What I was imagining.I promise I won't. But why hasn't she remembered it?
小僧、関わるなと言ったぞ。
Sorry.
まあ、そういうことだ。小僧、つまらん話をしに来たな。
No, I'm sorry.
掃除は終わったか?
Yes.
今答えてやったのは、その礼と思え。
Thank you. I bowed my head to him.
うん、また来い、小僧。
I will. Next time I will come with more fun topics. Yet again I bowed my head and left the room.、Oh. Our dorm room. Looking at the bedsheet hanging outside, I reminded myself of Kojirou-san's words. So Komari-san's brother, Takuya Kamikita, was already dead after all.Telling her the truth would just make her sad. That would literally mean destroying her dreams. So it would be better for her to let Takuya-san remain as a character of her dreams. But how come she didn't know he was dead? How come nobody let her know about it? They thought she would be too grieved. No, that can't be the reason. I was pretty sure Kojirou-san knew the reason, although I suppose I shouldn't try to pry anything more from him.Either way, I should keep this to myself. Well, I guess it's alright now.
なんかよくわかんねえけどよ。もう終わったのか?
Yeah.
なら、飯でも食いに行こうぜ。
Sure. There was no problem so long as I was the only one being troubled by this. That's what I told myself.All of a sudden, she called out my name in an unusually powerful voice. Yes? For reasons unknown, she seemed tense as a flagpole. Well, no, I don't.
じゃあ
She never bored me, this one.
ですね
Yeah.What?
出かけるときには忘れずに?
Don't forget what? She bent down, cradling her head in her arms. It was genuinely fun watching her act.
落ち着こう。
She meaninglessly pointed at me. No, you should calm down, Komari-san.
あれですよ。私とゴーですよ。
Go where?
デート、行っちゃいなよ。
I could understand how she was feeling, but I felt that being that bashful was more embarrassing in itself than asking somebody out. Well, it was very Komari-san, though. Sure, why not? Where will we go? On all accounts, you were being way too nervous. In fact, I could do nothing but calm down when I was with somebody else feeling that embarrassed. She took a deep breath and composed herself. Good, so where are we going? A lake?
Mizumi.
What lake? Okay. What is there? What? There. Well, on Saturday, the plan was to meet up at the school gates and then head out to the station together. I'll see you a little more then. I'm leaving.
今度は何だよ?
Well, just out to have fun, I guess. It was kind of embarrassing saying I was going on a date.
遊びって、俺は?
Sorry, can't take you. Why don't you do some weight training like always?
そんないつだって筋トレしてるわけじゃねえよ!
Look, those dumbbells seem amazingly heavy. Why don't you try them?
そんなんで…
I guided his hands to the dumbbells.
やらねえって…
And then I made him lift and lower them. Come on, shake them!
なんか楽しくなってきたぞ!
Thank God he's a muscle idiot.
よっしゃ! 今日も筋トレだ! お前も楽しんでこい!
Then I'll be off. Telling him not to forget to walk up, I left the room. I seemed to be 5 minutes ahead of the appointed time. I checked the time with my cell as I walked up to the school gate. Great! Date off with Komari. Okay, we're learning even more about her. She seems like a very nice girl. I don't know if she'll be as good as Nagisa, but still, I think she'll be interesting. Sweet! Bye!